Okay, guys, so as we said, we're gonna discuss our lesson, a pair of jeans. We've already read it before. I think on a Friday we finished it. But let us make a quick revision before we start solving the exercises, right? So the title of the story was A Pair of Jeans, okay? Even though we didn't have a clear ending for the story yet, by analyzing the title, we could understand that the ending of the story has to do with that pair of jeans, okay? So the story takes place in, or took place in a certain camping trip in the forest. And we learned that since the theme of it is about recreation, the story's theme is about recreation. It's related to recreation or having fun during your free time. It was a narrative story, and usually we understand narrative, or usually whenever we read any narrative story, we understand that it's about fun, it's about having good time, because it's a story. We all enjoy good stories, right?
Right.
Good. Sorry. So guys, the story took place, as I said before, in the forest, and they had a lovely day at the forest where they went fishing, enjoyed their time with their friends, etc. Until when it became so dark. Okay, what happened then? What happened to our narrator, since it was written in the first point of view? What happened to him? He faced a certain trouble. He thought that there was a monster behind him, and the story ended of all the characters laughing without telling us the reason why they did. But by analyzing the title, we could understand that maybe it was the shadow of that pair of jeans, okay? Also, if you look at the pictures on page 126 and 127, you can also understand the story well, okay? We call this visualizing. One type of visualizing or previewing is to just preview the stories, the pictures in the story, okay? So guys, directly let us start solving practice B. So the first question was, when did the narrator's companions run away? Companions from the word company, or mean the one who is accompanying him, yani the one, or here in this story, it was his brother-in-law, his sister, and his wife, okay? So when did they run away?
When
he heard elephant, slaves coming from behind.
So actually they run away after hearing a faint rustle of leaves and supposedly seeing something terrifying. So when I say supposedly, means maybe, or what they thought it was, a terrifying sound, okay? So this was a direct answer from the text. And the second question is, what does chaos broke loose in paragraph 7 mean? So what is the meaning of chaos broke loose? Yeah?
She turned back, the noise appeared.
Maybe. Okay.
That the noise was happening there.
Yeah, a lot of noise. So it means that everything actually went crazy and became unexplained. It was a complete chaos, we call it, okay? So the third question was, how did the narrator react to that strange situation? His reaction, usually when you're in his place, you would feel terrified. Maybe you'll scream, maybe you'll run away, okay? Because it's not something easy. What about you? What about our narrator? What did he simply do?
He got surprised and he thought that he's gonna die.
He sits on the ground and closes his eyes.
Okay, thank you guys for your suggestions. Actually, he froze. He didn't move at all, and he decided that he was going to just sit down. He remained sitting on his chair, and he just accepted his fate, okay? He said that maybe this is this. I'm gonna accept it like a man. So he simply froze, okay? The last question about what do you think will happen next, we've already discussed it. We said that Of course, since they left, it means that there wasn't anything to worry about. It was maybe related to their imagination, and since it was really dark, we had like shadows due to the campfire. Maybe by comparing the title, okay, to the story, we understood that maybe it was the shadow of the pair of jeans, and they thought that it was a monster just simply approaching them. Okay, here the answer varies, means that you can answer in any logical way that you find it. Okay, so all in all, this was like a summary of our lesson. Okay.